स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ वी आर डिस्कसिंग द सेकेंड पीयूसी चैप्टर सॉलिड स्टेट। सो फॉर बोर्ड एग्जामिनेशन सॉलिड स्टेट अलॉटेड मार्क्स इज सेवन मार्क्स, वन क्वेश्चन, टू मार्क्स and another one question, 5 marks. So total are 7 marks. So in the first PUC class, we have learned a definition of solid state, liquid state and gaseous state. So first one, we are discussing the introduction part of solid state. Introduction means a matter. Matter is also called as a substance. Matter is existed in three important states. First one, solid state. Second one, liquid state. Third one, gaseous state. First one, solid state, liquid state, and gaseous state. Existed state is a solid state, means the particles present in a solid state compactly arrangement, means closely packed. This is the one particle combined with the another particle. So these are the closely arrangement, means regular arrangement of constituent particles, general concept. So means in this one, there is a space between the particles, constituent particles. And in this gaseous state, the separation between the two particles is very large. So this is the one particle, another particle. This is the gas. So in a solid state, an example is a chalk piece or a wood or a table. And liquid state, example is the water. So this is the wood. And this is the gas, oxygen gas and nitrogen gas or atmospheric gases. So now we are discussing the solid state. An important part of this one is the existing states is depends upon existed state is depends upon two important factors. If the matter is existed in a solid state or a liquid state or a gaseous state, it depends upon the two important factors. So if two important factors, first one is the intermolecular force of attraction between the two particles. First factor is intermolecular force of attraction between two particles. Or intermolecular force of attraction between particles. And the second one is thermal energy or temperature. So if the matter is existed in a solid state, for example, if the matter existed in a solid state, So in this solid state, the intermolecular force of attraction is more. For example, this is the one particle or one molecule. So this molecule closely contact with the another particle. There is a strong intermolecular force of attraction between these two particles. Strong intermolecular force of attraction between these two particles. It means that the distance between the two particles, there is no distance between the two particles. Therefore, the thermal energy or temperature is low. Strong intermolecular force of attraction. Strong intermolecular force of attraction. And second point is low thermal energy. Low thermal energy. So based upon two factors, the solids, a force of attraction is more and lower thermal energy. And when you come to the liquid state, so in this one, the intermolecular force of attraction is less between the two particles. Less force of attraction. And second one is thermal energy is high comparing with the solid state. If you comparing the solid state, the temperature is higher and the intermolecular force of attraction is less or low. And when you come to the gaseous state, so in the gaseous state, in this one, very less force of attraction and more thermal energy. More thermal energy means higher temperature, the particles present in a substance or a matter can easily move from one place to another place. Therefore, the thermal energy high and the force of interaction is very, very less. Means intermolecular distance is increases. The distance between the two particles. So next one, a general properties or characteristics of solid state. General characteristics or properties of solid state. So first property, property number one, solids having definite shape, mass and volume. Solids having definite shape, mass and volume. Definite shape, mass and volume. And second one, solids are rigid in nature. Solids are rigid in nature due to the strong force of attraction between the two particles. There is no space between the two particles. Therefore, the solids are rigid in nature. And third one, solids having sharp melting point. Solids having sharp melting points. And fourth property, solids having incompressible. Solids are incompressible. Solids are incompressible. And the next one, solids are high density. Solids are high density. So these are the general properties or general characteristics of solids. First one is having a definite shape, mass and volume. Second one is solids are rigid in nature due to the strong intermolecular force of attraction between particles. And third one is solids having a sharp melting point. Sharp melting point in the sense, so these solids particles melt at a particular temperature. For example, solids are melt 75 degrees Celsius. This is called as a sharp melting point. But some of the states melts from 75 degrees Celsius to 100 degrees Celsius. So next one, the solids are incompressible, and this is also having a high density materials. High density materials. Solids are classified into two categories based upon nature of arrangement of constituent particles. Arrangement of constituent particles. Constituent particles. So the important classifications are, one is, so initially solid material or a solid state. So this solid state is classified into two categories. One is crystalline solids. Another one is amorphous solids. So generally crystalline and amorphous solids are, crystalline solids having a crystal nature. For example, sugar or a salt. So this is crystalline solids. Generally amorphous solids are powder form. Means soft in nature. And come to the definition part of crystalline solids. The definition part of crystalline solids. So in crystalline solids, the constituent particles are arranged in a three-dimensional constituent particles are arranged in a regular three-dimensional shape. definite regular three dimensional shape. So constituent particles arranged in regular three dimensional shape. For example, in a solid state, so any metal, a zinc metal or an iron metal or a copper metal, so these are all crystalline solids. And come to the salts like a sodium chloride NaCl or a potassium chloride KCl or a calcium chloride CaF2, etc. Or other examples of solid state, diamond, graphite, etc. So these are our examples of crystalline solids. So crystalline solids, it is also a type of solid in which the constituent particles are arranged in a regular manner in a three-dimensional shape. For example, solids like iron, zinc, copper, etc. or salts like sodium chloride or a potassium chloride or a calcium chloride. And another one is amorphous solids. In this amorphous solids, the constituent particles are arranged in irregular shape. Therefore, the examples for amorphous solids, are rubber, or a glass material, plastic, etc. So these are the examples of amorphous solids. Common examples: rubber, glass, plastic. So now we are discussing the types of solids. In these types of solids, it is classified on the basis of arrangement of constituent particles. So one is a crystalline solids, another one is the amorphous solids. So crystalline solids means the constituent particles arranged in a regular three-dimensional shape. For example, is in a solid state, a zinc or a iron or a copper metals, or you can take the examples of salts, sodium chloride, potassium chloride, calcium chloride, etc. Or other examples are diamond, graphite, sulfur, monoclinic and rhombic sulfur. So these are our examples of crystalline solids. And another one is amorphous solids. In this amorphous solids, the constituent particles are arranged in an irregular manner. The examples are rubber, glass, plastic, etc. And the next one, we are discussing the differences between crystalline solids, and amorphous solids. Crystalline solids हमारे पास सॉलिड्स. सो वी नो दैट द डेफिनेशंस ऑफ बोथ सॉलिड्स. इन द क्रिस्टलाइन सॉलिड्स द कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट पार्टिकल्स आर अरेंज्ड इन अ फर्स्ट डिफरेंस. द कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट पार्टिकल्स अरेंज्ड इन ए रेगुलर 3D शेप, थ्री डायमेंशनल शेप, एंड इट इज अरेंज्ड इन ए कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट पार्टिकल्स अरेंज्ड इन ए इरेगुलर शेप. Irregular shape. This is the one difference between crystalline solids and amorphous solids. And the second one, a crystalline solids having a sharp melting points. These are having sharp melting points. And in case of amorphous solids, these solids do not possess sharp melting points. These solids do not possess sharp melting points. And the third difference is, in case of crystalline solids, these crystalline solids having a long range of order, these are having long range order. Long range order. These are having short range order. Short range order. And fourth one, crystalline solids are anisotropic. These are anisotropic. Means the crystalline solids, physical properties of crystalline solids like conductivity or refractive index measured to get the same value, so that is called as a anisotropy. And fourth one, so in case of amorphous solids, these are isotropic in nature. These are isotropic in nature. And fifth one, a crystalline solid having fixed enthalpy of fusion. Enthalpy of fusion means have with the same as that of the melting point. So crystalline solids having fixed enthalpy of fusion. It does not having Does not have fixed enthalpy of fusion. enthalpy of fusion. And another difference between the crystalline solids and amorphous solids. So crystalline solids are also called as true solids. Crystalline solids are also called as a true solids, and amorphous solids is also called as a supercooled liquids or pseudo solids. Is also called as a pseudo solids or supercooled liquids. And another difference for crystalline solids and amorphous solids, when cut with a sharp edged tools, for example crystalline solids, when cut with sharp edged tools to get plane surfaces. But when you cut with the, in case of amorphous solids, when you cut with the sharp edged tools, does not get plane surfaces. For example, this is a crystalline solid. When this crystalline solid is cut with the sharp edged tools and it is converted into two plane surfaces solids. So this one is true. And when, for example, in case of amorphous solids, so this is the amorphous solid. When cut with the sharp edged tools to get the like this, means rough surfaces or irregular surfaces. So this is the differences between crystalline solids and amorphous solids. So for the point of examination, so this question arises in your annual examination or a midterm examination or test 2 marks question. Write the differences between crystalline solids and amorphous solids. So you can write any 2 to 3 differences.